Hello, in this video we'll go through some of the list operations. We'll start with the in operator. So in operator helps to check whether an element is present in the list. So for example, here we have a list of words, the age of reason, and we want to check whether the is present in words list. So all we need to do is say the string the in words. So it returns a boolean value, which is true. And for example, then if we take unreason in words, it is not present, it returns false. So in checks whether the element is present in the list or not. Similarly, what we have is a not operator. For example, here is a list nums 148. We are checking x equal to 10 not in nums. So 10 is not in nums list, so it is true. We have list append function. As the name suggests, what it does is it appends to the list. So you have a list 5, 8, 10 and you have appended 14. So the new list is 5, 8, 10, 14. So these are very intuitive kind of operations, and Python excels in that. It does not give you any surprise. For example, now the length of the list is, you use a function length of numbers and it gives you a list. So length comes out as 3. Let's say you want to insert at a specific index, right? You want to insert 100 at index 2, which means you want to insert at the position where 10 is present. So when you do that, what you get is 5, 8, 110. So it has taken 100, inserted at the second position and moved the other elements to the right. So that's why you get 5, 8, 110. Index method finds the first occurrence of list item and returns the index. So for example, you want to search the element 10. Now 10 is present in two places. So what index does is it gives you the first occurrence of the list item. So here it will print 0, 1, 2. So we have 2. If the element is not present in the list, and if you are searching for that, it is going to give a index error. It will give a value error. So you get a value error 100 not in list, because 100 is not present in the list, right? For when we say in equal to nums.index 100, 100 is not present in the list. That's why we are getting a value error. Similarly, there are many more intuitive functions. So for example, you want to find the maximum of these numbers. All you do is you use the max function. You want to find the minimum of this list, you use minimum. You want to reverse this list, you do a nums.reverse. Nums.reverse, what it does is it changes the list in place, right? And if you want to remove a particular element 10, you know, you just call num.remove 10. The catch here is it will only remove the first 10. It will not remove all the 10s. You know, so let me run it. Right, and here are the values. So maximum is 12. Minimum is 5. The reverse, it has reversed the list and it has removed 10, right? When you remove 10, what you get is, you know, the first 10 has been removed, but other 10 is still present in the list. Now, let's say we want to remove all values of 10. What we do is we combine with the while loop. What we say is while 10 in nums, nums.remove 10. So it will keep removing 10 until it removes all the 10 from the list. So let me run this. So the list after removing 10 is 5, 8, 12. So here we have removed all the 10 valued elements. So this is in a nutshell all the functions of list. There are many more, but these are all very intuitive functions. As discussed, Python does not give any surprise. Thank you.